Okubo, an artist just returned from studying in Europe, found herself caught in the executive order that separated Japanese Americans and incarcerated them in camps located in some of the most desolate land of this country. Of her trip to Topaz, the concentration camp near Delta in central Utah, she wrote, "Restless from exhaustion, everyone was wakeful on the second night. Nothing functioned well on this old relic of a train. The steam heat could not be turned off, so the car was overheated and stuffy. About 2 o'clock in the morning, someone shouted, 'The Great Salt Lake!' There was a general scramble, but I could hear the ripple of the water. It was pitch black. An hour later, the train pulled into the huge railroad station at Ogden. I have a dim recollection of seeing ice and water being put on the train, but do not know how long we stopped here. The train arrived in Delta at 8 o'clock, but we were all too tired to be excited. The captain of our car was fast asleep. Officials were darting about, and there was some commotion. The chief of project reports at Topaz came on board the train and handed to each of us the first copy of the Topaz Times. We chuckled as we read, 'Topaz, the jewel of the desert.' The paper described the camp and gave instructions to the newcomers. The mountain called Topaz loomed over the desert. They were far from home. Years later, when Mine saw that many who had experienced living in camps such as Topaz looked on that time with shame, she courageously wrote a memoir, a kind of graphic novel, to claim the experience and to demand restorative justice. This is her journey to Topaz."
See the journey's on. We